माननीय अध्यक्ष जी, प्रश्नकाल क्वेश्चन नंबर 81, श्री जी लक्ष्मी नारायण।
थैंक यू स्पीकर जी।
माननीय मंत्री जी,
सर क्वेश्चन नंबर 81, द डिटेल्स ऑफ द टोटल नंबर ऑफ सेंटर्स ऑफ एक्सीलेंस फॉर स्किल डेवलपमेंट
एस्टैब्लिश। सभापति जी, प्रश्न का उत्तर सभा पटल पे
सेक्टर्स दे फोकस ऑन द डिटेल्स ऑफ द नंबर ऑफ COAs ऑपरेशनल इन कोच ई स्टेट डिस्ट्रिक्ट वाइज, द डिटेल्स ऑफ द नंबर ऑफ बेनिफिशियरीज ट्रेंड बाय द COAs इन ईच स्टेट इंक्लूडिंग द डिटेल्स ऑफ प्लेसमेंट्स ऑफ एम्प्लॉइज आउटकम सर, द डिटेल्स ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल आउटले फॉर एस्टैब्लिशिंग एंड मेंटेनिंग दी COAs अलॉन्ग विद द फंडिंग पैटर्न फॉलोड बाय देयर ऑपरेशन वेदर गवर्नमेंट फंडेड पब्लिक प्राइवेट पार्टनरशिप एक्सेट्रा, whether there are any proposals to expand or establish additional COAs in the future across the country, especially in Andhra Pradesh, sir. And if so, the details thereof, and if not, the reasons thereof. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. I congratulate the Member of Parliament on asking me a very pertinent question. Andhra Pradesh government has taken substantial steps and given a lot of credence and recognition to the space of skilling. I'd like to inform the House and the Honourable Member that the entire system of giving national recognition to centres of excellence is designed to bring more visibility to impactful, credible institutions. We are providing a national recognition to these institutions. The Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship issued guidelines with this regard in 2019. A total of 6 COEs have been recognized, given that status by the ministry. But apart from this, a total of 202 centers of excellence have been established with the help of our sector skill councils. The 36 sector skill councils, as you know, are the principal bodies where we involve industry. In fact, these organizations are led by industry, and they work in coordination under the ministry as well. Sir, out of the 202, because the Honourable MP asked me about Andhra Pradesh, a total of 8 centres of excellence have been established in Andhra Pradesh. Thank you.
Supplementary. Sir, my constituency, Anandpur, receives sunlight all around the year, sir, and it is home to 2 major solar plants contributing 62% of the state's renewable energy capacity, sir. A world-class energy university is also proposed to be established in Anandpur, owing to the region's immense renewable energy potential. Under the visionary leadership of Nara Chandrababu Naidu Garu, Andhra Pradesh has recently introduced the AP Integrated Clean Energy Policy 2024, sir, targeting the generation of 78.5 gigawatts of solar and 35 gigawatts of wind power over the next 5 years, sir. Given Anandpur's prominent role in renewable energy and its potential to drive the state ambitious targets, sir, I would like to ask the minister, is there any plan to establish a center of excellence for skill development and R&D in renewable energy in Anandpur to create a green workforce and strengthen the clean energy system, sir? Thank you.
I thank the honourable member. It is true that Andhra Pradesh is a leader in the space of technologies with regards to green jobs. The Honourable MP has asked me specifically about the green job sector. I'd like to inform him that out of the 36 sector councils, one of our councils relates specifically to the space of green jobs, and there is a lot of potential. For instance, the PM Surya Ghar Muft Bijli scheme is targeting 1 lakh jobs. Our ministry is working in coordination with the ministry and the scheme. Under PMKVY4, we are targeting to create a large number of jobs under this scheme. The Green Hydrogen Mission targets 6 lakh jobs in the value chain, and 50,000 ODT training is also targeted by the mission. Likewise, our ministry is working in consonance with that scheme as well. Sir, our Green Sector Council has trained 582,579 candidates in the space of solar energy, waste management, wind energy, green hydrogen, small hydro and other green jobs. honorable MP has asked specifically with regards to setting up a center of excellence in the state of Andhra Pradesh. I would recommend that the honorable MP can work with the state government, can identify credible institutions that are active in that space, and can recommend the same to my ministry. We will follow due process.
माननीय सदस्यगणों, प्रश्नकाल आपका समय है। मैं आग्रह करता हूं कि प्रश्नकाल को आप चलने दें। कृपया अपनी अपनी सीट पर बिराजें।